Alright, so this is the second video response to questions that you guys asked about my video series on the Lifer Curve. We already hit maximum revenue, that was in the first video. In this one, I want to talk about make money and aggregate. Because one of the things that I said was, this is how much money the government would make, and some people legitimately took some offense at that. Now, some people, libertarians in particular, there were a lot of that the government is stealing our money. Well, honestly, I don't agree with that. But the government certainly doesn't make money, right? It creates money, but it doesn't make money the way that we think of as a business, right? So that was not a great term for me to use, and I accept that. So aggregate, I don't delve into deep economic terms a lot, and this isn't a big one, but this curve is an aggregate curve, which means that it is made up of several small curves of different types that look different ways depending on what we're talking about. So these could be a business curve tax, right? So how much tax do we charge businesses? This could be a tax down here on those who make less than $50,000. This could be the top marginal tax rate of those making over $400,000 or $1 million or whatever numbers we select. But all of these small curves down here turn into this big aggregate curve. And one of the things that I really need to emphasize is that my focus, specifically when talking about the GOP tax cuts, is not this big aggregate curve, because we legitimately don't know what that number will necessarily be. My point is the maximum top marginal rate, right? So that top marginal tax rate for individuals, the wealthy, as well as a secondary one associated with businesses. And I really kind of intertwined those in those first videos. And again, it was 4 minutes long, so I apologize. So those are two separate curves. Those are two separate values, right? One might be here, one might be here. We don't necessarily know. And again, I'm going to offer some ideas on them. But there's the top marginal tax rate for the wealthy, and there is the business income tax. I think we can also add one other at the moment because it's been split out, and that is going to be capital gains taxes, which is taxes on your stocks, for example, when you sell them and stuff like that. So non-income gains. And those have been separated from income gains. So I'm going to walk through all three of those.